now for your weekly news that you should care about. Here's Jean.
Hey guys, it's me, Jean from NC, with the news. I literally have like 50 stories, so I'm going to go just so you know. All of the links for all of these stories in the sidebar. So, police in Oregon are searching for a 14-year-old girl, Elvia Morales, who was kidnapped by a man, Juan Martinez Martinez, who used to work for her father. That was as of August 7th. So if you know anything, check the link in the sidebar. Victoria Beckham coming to American Idol as the new Paula Abdul. What do you guys think? There was a bear loose in L.A. There was in a neighborhood in L.A. It was about 3 to 4 years old and about 250 pounds. Eventually it disappeared into a storm drain. The London Zoo debuted Asian cubs. Asian lion cubs. Little siblings. They're so cute. One person died in a fiery crash in Detroit, which police were chasing a stolen pickup truck. When it collided with a minivan, struck a utility pole, and then burst into flames. Driver of the minivan had minor injuries. 3-year-old elephant that lost her right leg when she stepped on a landmine got a prosthetic limb on Saturday. I'm not kidding you. Link over there. Japan's prime minister expressed deep regret over the suffering his country inflicted on Asian countries during World War II in a solemn ceremony on Saturday that marked the 64th anniversary of Tokyo's surrender. Isn't that cool? A New York shopkeeper who shot 4 men during a robbery was back on the job Friday, one day after the confrontation. Charles Gus Augusto Jr. killed 2 of the robbers and wounded the other 2. No charges were filed. Okay, so you guys know that story about the 2 planes that crashed recently in the Hudson River again. Get this. Here's the other side of the story. The air traffic controller handling the small plane involved in the deadly crash with the helicopter was chatting on the phone about a dead cat at the airport. I'm not kidding you. That's why he was distracted. Wedding in Kuwait turned to tragedy because 41 women and children died after a fire broke out in a tent during the wedding. Isn't that sad? Russian officials say 76 people so far are dead in an explosion that happened at their hydroelectric plant, the country's biggest hydroelectric plant. They actually have video of it. It's really interesting. Okay, so Walt Disney World spokesman said that a performer was injured. Excuse the dog, while performing a tumbling role for the Indiana Jones epic stunt. Spectacular at Disney's Hollywood Studios, part of the Orlando theme park, you know, so, yeah. This was like the 3rd injury in as many months or something, 3rd injury this year, something like that, link in the sidebar. Okay, so you know that couple I said there was a hit, you know, their death was a hit, they adopted all those kids. You know, they left like 13 kids after they were killed. Well, their 6-year-old son, I'm sorry, the son, who's autistic, was in his parents' bedroom when the invasion happened. He was threatened to be killed. He saw his parents get killed. He saw everything. So, anybody else here that's Celine Dion pregnant, 41, she's due in May. Maybe she'll actually have a boy this time. Oh, sorry. 6-year-old was mowed down by a yellow cab driver as he attempted to drive to cross the street. Cab driver was on the cell phone. California, yet again, getting hit with the wildfires. Minnesota man is accusing police officers of brutally beating him during a traffic stop. Police Chief Tim Dolan reviewed the dash cam video of February's incident, February, and we're just now hearing about it, and concluded that some officers' actions were a cause for concern. The FBI is now looking into this, I'm telling you. So, over in Europe, there was an 11-year-old girl, Paige Dean, who cheated death by jumping out of her car just before it rolled off a cliff, 250 feet drop. I don't lie about these things. Link in the sidebar. So, while we're still in a recession, Japan's economy has turned around. They're no longer in a recession. Oklahoma car dealer decided that wanted a unique way for those clunkers that you bring in, trade in for the big government rebates. Yeah, he crushed him with a monster truck. It was kind of cool. Video in the sidebar. So, you know, we've had a couple of storms already, and this last one was named Hurricane Bill. But I'm bummed. Sorry. Inside joke, because my husband's name is Bill. A couple years ago, there was a Hurricane Gene, spelled the same way as my name. Anyway, he was a Category 4. He's also proud. Anyway, I gotta stop saying that. Authorities say former college professor and his wife were apparently attacked and killed by nearly a dozen dogs along a rural road where their bodies were found mutilated. Isn't that sad? The son went to go check on him and found them. So, South Korea's former President Kim Dae-jung passed away, and tens of thousands of mourners turned out for the funeral. Wow. Did you guys hear about Milwaukee's mayor, Tom Barrett? He was attacked by some dude and shattered his hand and knocked out two of his front teeth, trying to defend a grandmother who was screaming for someone to call 911. Now, how sad is that? He's back at work today. Only a couple days afterwards. Is that crazy? Crematorium in Dallas, Texas is under investigation for allegedly leaving human remains strewn about the property, like in the parking lot and all sorts of other places. A former employee ratted them out. Phoenix police found two young children taken when armed by... Phoenix police found two young children taken when armed gunmen burst into a house Tuesday of last week. The children, a 2-year-old boy and an 11-month-old girl, were apparently kidnapped Tuesday morning, but were found unharmed. So, Little League, you guys, the World Series, you know, Staten Island, you're going to be representing in the World Series. Yeah. So, link in the sidebar on that. Year and a half after a father discovered the remains of a baby boy stuffed in a suitcase behind his Texas rental property, he found two more bodies of children under the same rented home. I'm not kidding. Is that not weird? So now they're searching everywhere, you know, doing DNA, because there's no evidence of how the three babies died, but they have reopened the case from a year ago. So, a New Zealand extreme sports company has admitted two health and safety charges relating to the death of a British woman. She was in an extreme sport. She got caught underwater and died, and so now her family is considering another suit against them, now that they have admitted to those charges.